the bishop's finger strikes again. And remember, life is too short to be drinking shitty beer.
Welcome to another edition of Bands, Bikes and Booze Reviews. Today, we've got Bishop's Finger, Shepherd Neame Brewery from Kent, the oldest brewer in Britain. Really got high hopes for this. They're a local brewer. Well, I say local, they're just down the road, a few miles down the road from me in Kent. And yeah, they've got a long history and a long pedigree. Before I talk more about that, I just want to show you this t-shirt. Okay, this is a bar in Dunkirk in France, and we did a tour there last year on the bikes. I think it was about 12 or 13 of us, and we ended up in that bar, and it was great. They do some really good beer in there. You know, admittedly it's France, there's not going to get much good beer there, but they had some good ales in there from Belgium and stuff, and really nice people, great music. I suggest if you're in Dunkirk, get yourself down there, look it up. It's called the Jolly Roger, and it's like a hotel as well, so you can stay there and everything. Really good place, recommend it. The owners are fantastic, real nice people. Anyway, that's out of the way. Back to Bishop's Finger. Now, first of all, I want to talk about the name. It sounds like something from a Carry-On film. The Bishop's Finger. It's not. It actually relates to the shape of the road signs that were around in sort of medieval times, and these pointed the way to, I think it's Canterbury Cathedral, where Thomas Becket's body lay, that pilgrims used to go, and this would point the way. I'm just going to give you a close up of the label. There you go. See this here? That is the Bishop's Finger sign, so it basically looks like that. That's where it gets its name from. So that's that cleared up. Upholding a great tradition of very odd English ale names. Now you know. Okay. It's a pint bottle. They class this as Kentish dark ale. It is 5.4% in the volume. So it's a sort of a medium strength. They call it strong ale, but to be honest, nowadays this is sort of average. Let's dive in and see what it's got going for it. Okay, so here's the cap. Cool. Oh, I'll get onto that in a minute. There's the cap. It is a shepherd's crook, or a bishop's crook. The two are interchangeable, so I can see what they've done there. Yeah, very clever shepherd name. Yeah. To me, smells like a stout or a porter. It's got that burnt barley smell to it, and a lot of malt there, and that's about it. But let's pour it out and see what's going on. There's a fair bit of carbonation in there. And the colour is a very, very dark amber, or very, very light ruby, whatever way you want to look at that. But let me see what's going on here. Yeah, it's got like that burnt barley, porter and stout smell to it, which is unusual for an ale. I'd expect this to be very, very malty, but it's got the characteristics of a porter. But let's give it a go. Let's see what's going on. Mm. And there's the malt. Okay, what are we getting? We're getting malt. We're getting chocolate, dark chocolate malt. Very, very slight hops. Very slight. And there's fruit. There's an element of fruit to it as well. But that is just overwhelmingly like a dark chocolate, almost coffee-like taste to it. It's quite nice. They say it's strong Kentish ale, or Kentish strong ale. Not strong Kentish ale, Kentish strong ale. I can see what they mean by strong. There are some strong flavours in there, definitely. As I say, the aftertaste is bitter, chocolate, coffee, strong coffee. Almost like a porter, as I say, but not quite, which is good. And as it's going down, you're getting a layer of sort of caramel and slightly sweet notes, but then it's just, you're just overwhelmed with the bitterness. And that probably does come from some of the hops that have been put in there, as well as the barley, which I'm assuming has been roasted. If not, it certainly tastes like that. But I quite like it. I wouldn't say it's Shepherd Neame's best ale. I mean, that 1698 stuff that they did was just sublime. That was amazing stuff. This is not bad. I wouldn't go to town on it as much as I do with the 1698 and the Whitstable Bay, which is obviously, it's a different style, but how many could I drink of them? Not too many. I think the bitterness would just be too much after a while. Enough, one or two bottles would be enough for me. It just hasn't got that Moorish drinkability to it. People who are fond of the sort of porters and the stouts may like this. So what would I give that? I'd give it a 6 out of 10. And it's nice in small doses. A bottle, maybe two at the most, would be enough for me. And I love stout. I do like stout. I love Guinness. I love all the, you know, the Guinness export. I love that. I'm a fan of the porters, the chocolate porters and stuff like that. But that falls somewhere between, to me anyway, to my taste. And as I say, all these reviews are just what I'm tasting. It's not what they say in the brewery, what they say on the notes about the beer. It's just what I'm tasting, and that to me falls between, like they say, a strong ale and a porter. And it's just not lighting my fire to give it more than 6, 6.5 tops. So yeah, would I recommend it? Yeah, I would recommend it, because people have different tastes, and people that do like them sort of bitter malts and the dark beers and the stouts and the porters, I think you'd like that if you like them. But for me, it's one or two would be enough. So yeah, 6, 6.5 out of 10. I'm being a bit generous there. 6.5 out of 10. It's a local beer. It's got a great name. The kids in every British person's mind thinks that's something out of a Carry On film, you know, sort of a character that Kenneth Williams would be playing, you know, the bishop's finger strikes again. And remember, life is too short to be drinking shitty beer. Like and subscribe when a puppy gets it. Isn't that right, Purse? Yeah, get off.